All right, guys, we got a group of awesome guys here today. They came and visited from all over the country, and we're gonna be walking around the facility and just checking out some really awesome snakes. But I'm gonna let them introduce themselves first, and we'll get right to it.
Hi, I'm Brian from Bayma Exotics, coming from Maryland.
Hey, I'm Jason from Abe's Exotic Reptiles. I'm from Chicago.
I'm Adam from Morph Bite Design, coming in from New York. I just got in yesterday.
So always fun, we have really good ball python friends to chat with snakes and talk through projects. When you guys leave, I'm gonna be more energized for some of this stuff because I just get some cool feedback. So let's go look at some awesome snakes. What do you say?
Do it. Yeah.
Okay. So the first animal that I've selected to show you guys today is a lace Batman. This Batman is just absolutely crazy and stands out from all the ones that have been produced because of the cleanliness of this thing. Clean contrast, it's what everybody's kind of looking for. You get these jet black darks sitting right next to these super clean oranges. And to me, this thing is just spectacular. This is the first choice of my snakes that I'm gonna be showing today. Okay, so the next one I wanna show you guys is a Trojan. This is a project that I've been invested in now for a little bit, and I find this thing to be amazing, and let me talk about why. So first of all, the cleanliness of this thing. It's so super clean. This is an adult, and look at the color that's still being retained here. It's still got these vibrant reds, kind of a little of copper tone happening to it, some flaming coming up the sides, and to me, it's a little bit of like a hybrid Ultramel, Monarch, and it falls somewhere in between, but this thing as an adult, you know, to me, this one really stands out. Again, a project I'm into. Can't wait to see what happens with this over the next couple years. Super excited about this one and excited to see this one here today. Okay, so the next one I want to show you guys is another project that I'm really heavily involved in. I think it's kind of the big up and coming project that a lot of people are into right now. I personally think it's got so much room to grow and so much to be done with it, and it's just getting tapped into right now. That is a desert ghost clown. There's just so much to do with this. So you take a clown, which is obviously amazing on its own, you throw desert ghost into it, and you have a clown that essentially doesn't turn brown when it gets older. It's amazing, it retains the colors. You can stack any kind of codom genes on this thing to increase the color. For example, Orange Dream. I feel like Orange Dream would be a perfect complement to a DG clown to help clean it up, kind of reduce the speckling in here a little bit. But look at this thing. This is an adult clown with colors that are just vibrant and popping. Head stamp that's still visibly just popping still, and everything about this thing makes me excited. It's rare to see a clown that kind of holds all this contrast, you know, as it becomes an adult. Unless you have a dark colored clown, this generally doesn't happen, but Desert Ghost likes to retain those dark colors, and when you stack other stuff on here, magic happens. So to me, DG clown, man, this thing's crazy. Okay, the last animal that I chose in this room that I really wanted to feature is this pure insanity right here. This is a chocolate Pompeii. It is a chocolate yellow belly red striped spot nose clown. It's also a dark knight, which to me, it's my favorite morph that Justin's ever created. It's easy to tell why. Look at these crazy thick lines. It's just the thick contrast, the pattern, it's so clean, the giant flames coming up the sides, and there's just so much contrast here. To me, I thought that the Dark Knight was kind of the pinnacle, and then I saw this thing, and it looks like it's just highlighted with like mascara all the way through. Crazy head stamp, crazy contrast, amazing animal. I will own this one day.
First, I'd like to show you the redhead spot-nosed clown. This is a project I'm interested in. It's just unique. There's really nothing that's truly similar to it. You know, it kind of reduces it down the dorsal. You know, the head stamp is very unique too. It washes it out. It's ground level, so I really love to see where this project's gonna go. I've been kind of thinking about jumping in this. Maybe I'll jump into it this season. I love it. You know, really excited with this one. And the second one I'd like to show you is Freeway NG Lavender. This thing is just screaming. I don't think the camera could possibly pick this up, but you know, it is the craziest orange I've ever seen in a ball python. Yeah, wow, look at this thing. The last one I'd like to show you guys is absolutely the craziest clown I've ever seen. And you know, you've all seen it before. I just want to show you guys just an update on it. It's just wild. Yeah, this is the Kraken. I mean, in person, I can't describe it. It's bananas. It's just wild. It really, there's nothing that comes close in my opinion.
All right, so this is a special lace clown. Luckily, I was told by a good friend of mine Mike from Osmond Reptiles that Justin was about to release a video on special clowns. Mike had a het clown for me, and once I saw the video, I was very happy that I got into the project, and then that was one of the main things when I came here. I wanted to see a special clown in person. I'm roaming around and I see a special lace clown. I was amazed by it, and then I look right above, there's a special lace yellow belly clown, and it got even better. So this is the ODYB special spot nose clown. So a lot more genes put into the special clown, and it just makes it look awesome. I just like how the alien heads, it's all speckled, and just like the color running up it, and then the oranges running down the back. I think spot nose with clown, a lot of combos, you know, I personally like, so.
Awesome.
All right, so this is the last one I want to show, and it's really for my daughter. She asked me, does he have pides? And I kind of laughed because she's 7 years old, and I was like, yeah, he definitely has some pides. So this one right here is a ODYB Dreamsicle, which is just beautiful, and I think she'll appreciate seeing this video and seeing this beautiful snake.
All right, hope you guys enjoyed that. I think we should just do all our videos that way from now on, just bring people in to do them for me. And what do I owe you guys now? Is it, you paid by the snake or by the hour?
$1 cool.
Yeah, gotcha, you got it, man.
Oh, awesome.
$1 doesn't work for me, but I'll take a chocolate Pompeii, please.
Actually, I'll take one of those too.
All right, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to tune in next week. Appreciate all of you guys. Be sure to follow all these guys on their channel. We'll put it all in the description below. Now like and subscribe.